Hello everyone, welcome to the Frontend Crash Course. In the previous lecture, we've learned about the Vue router and Vue component. Today, I'm going to show you how to develop a login component and how to make it look good using PrimeVue and PrimeFlex. Let's start by creating a new file, loginuser.vue, inside the component folder. To remind, there are three main sections in the Vue component: script, template, and style. We declare the script section with the script setup tag and set the language to TS, which means TypeScript. It's basically the same thing as what we wrote in the HomeView component. The next section is a template, declared using the template tag. In this section, we'll write dynamic HTML tags, such as a div block like this. I said dynamic because it's not plain HTML, but we have some Vue syntaxes that allow us to dynamically render the HTML element. The third section is style, where we can write custom CSS code to make our HTML elements look good. However, since we haven't had any visible elements yet, we don't have to declare this section for now. Although we can write everything ourselves, it will be much faster to reuse existing open source component. And that's exactly why Vue is so cool. With its component-based design, we can easily reuse a lot of things that other people have already developed and save a ton of time in development. PrimeVue is one of those very powerful suites of open source Vue components, which will help us a lot in making beautiful UI without having to write too much code. Let's follow the instructions on this page to install it. We're using Vite for development, so let's see how to set up PrimeVue in a Vite project. First, let's run npm install PrimeVue in the terminal. Once it's done, PrimeVue will show up in the package.json file of the project. Next, we'll have to add it to our application as a plugin. To do that, I'm going to copy this import statement and paste it to the main.ts file. Then simply call app.use PrimeVue to register the plugin to the app. After that, we must decide the theme we want to use, styled or unstyled. Styled means that the look of the component will be based on existing themes, such as Material, Bootstrap, or Prime 1, while unstyled allows us to define a custom theme ourselves. I'm going to choose styled mode with the auto light green theme as shown in this statement. So let's copy and paste it to the top of the main.css file. Make sure to add an at sign before the import and a semicolon at the end. Alright, now PrimeVue is ready. Let's go back to the loginuser.vue file to use it. First, I want to have an input field for the username with the user icon in front of it. For this, we will use the input group component. It can be found in the PrimeVue's documentation. Here we can see an example of how the component looks and how to import and use this component. Let's copy this import statement and paste it inside the script section. Then let's copy the sample code and paste it inside the div tag of the template section. Pretty easy, isn't it? Now if we check the browser, there's still nothing here except the welcome message. That's because the login user component we've just written hasn't been used anywhere. In order to show it on the UI, we have to add it to the home view component. Normally, when we write login user like this, VS Code should recognize the component and import it automatically for us. However, sometimes it has issues of looking up new components, so we might need to write the import manually like this. Here I use relative import path, and we can check if the path is correct by pressing command while hovering the mouse on top of it, and click on the link to see whether it can bring us to the right file. In this case, the import path is correct, but somehow VS Code still shows a red line. I think it might be a bug of VS Code or something. When it happens, what we can do is simply restart VS Code, and the problem will be gone. Now we can add the login user component to the home view, right below the welcome message. Okay, this time in the browser, we will see that something has shown up. But it doesn't look like the username input field as we expected. So there's definitely some bugs in the login user component. Alright, I see. Here we are using another component called input text, but we haven't imported it yet. Let's take advantage of VS Code's suggestion feature by deleting the last character T and retype it again. VS Code will suggest the input text component with its import path. When we press enter, the import statement will be automatically added to the script section. Okay, this time the username field has shown up on the screen. However, we still don't see the user icon in front of it. The reason for that is we haven't installed the Prime Icons library. On the PrimeVue documentation page, we should look for Prime Icons and follow the instruction. First, run npm install Prime Icons in the terminal. Then copy this import and paste it to the main.css file. Don't forget to add the @ and the semicolon. After saving the file, we can go back to the Simple Bank page. Now the user icon has appeared, exactly as we wanted. However, I noticed something strange here. The welcome message is not green anymore. Somehow its color has changed to black. Let's check the home view to see what's going on here. Okay, I see. Here the class name should be green instead of .green. I guess when I performed an undo before, when adding the login user component, it also changed this class name to the previous value. But it's fine now. On the UI, we can see a nice green welcome message. Next, I'm going to create another input field for the password. Let's duplicate the whole input group that we wrote for the username. Then change the placeholder of the input text to password. We should also change the user icon to something else. You can find the list of all Prime icons on the PrimeVue documentation page. There are many popular icons here, but I think this lock icon is the most suitable one for our password field. All we have to do is copy its name, PyLock, and paste it to the class property of the I tag, replacing the PyUser1. Now let's save this file and check it on the UI. As you can see, now we have two fields with different icons, one for the username and one for the password. Let's try and put something into those fields. The username value looks fine. However, it's not right for the password value to show up as clear text like that. For security reasons, the password should be hidden, so other people cannot see its value when users enter their password. To make that happen, we have to add a type property to the input text and set it to password. So now the input field is no longer a plain text field, but a password field. And thus, if we write something in this field, its value will be hidden. Now, although the two input fields are functioning, they still don't look very nice because they are still sticking together. So let's learn how to add some spaces between them. It's possible to add some custom CSS to the style section of the component, but I'm going to show you a faster way, which is to take advantages of an open source CSS utility called PrimeFlex. Just like PrimeVue is a set of predefined view component, PrimeFlex is a set of predefined responsive CSS library that helps you quickly customize the look of your element. We can install it by running npm install PrimeFlex in the terminal. After it is installed, we must import PrimeFlex in the main.css file. As you can see in its documentation page, there are many utilities for different use cases, such as layout, flexbox, grid, background, border, spacing, sizing, etc. In our case, we will use flexbox. It is a flexible layout that allows responsive elements within a container to be automatically arranged depending on the size of the viewport. We can specify the direction in which the items are displayed. For example, if the flex direction is row, then the items will be arranged horizontally like this. While if the direction is column, The items will be arranged vertically as shown here. We can also specify the gap or spaces between the items. The gap can be set for both row and columns together or separately. We use the gap, row gap, or column gap prefix to tell it whether we want the gap to be applied to row, column, or both. The value follow those prefixes will decide the width of the gap. Bigger number means bigger gap. In our case, we want the two input fields to be arranged vertically with gaps between rows. So in the login user component, we'll add a class property to the most outer div. Here we can specify a list of CSS classes we want to use, which are flex, flex column, and then row gap 6 for instance. Now if we go back to the page, we'll see that the username and password fields are no longer stick together. But there seems to be too many spaces between them, so I'm gonna reduce the gap to row gap 5. Okay, now it looks much better, with just enough spaces between the two. And that's it for today's lecture. We've learned how to use PrimeVue and PrimeFlex to build a good-looking login form with two input fields for the username and password. In the next video, we'll learn how to store those input values in variables and add a login button to the form. Thank you for watching this video. Happy learning, and see you in the next lecture.